obviously a terrific hockey game between two really good hockey teams. Really pleased with the outcome, obviously, and this team has battled all year long, and they've dealt with adversity, and, you know, when their backs have been against the wall, that's when they've been their best. And going into overtime, and I saw the way we started overtime, I felt really good. I felt confident that we were going to get the job done, and we did. So, obviously, I'm thrilled with winning our second hockey championship.
I'll take questions from Cassidy around.
Cassidy, can you take us through your game-winning goal?
Yeah, I just hopped on the ice, and I think it was Barnes had the puck, and she kind of passed it or mishandled it right to the center, and I picked it up. I kind of had a step on the other defenseman. I don't know who it was. And I knew to use my size, so I kind of stuck my left leg out to block a stick and pulled it to my backhand and went blocker side, yeah.
Aaron, there was a sequence there where it seemed like the net was completely wide open and you managed to sprawl out and get it. So what's going through your mind in that whole sequence there in overtime?
Basically, I feel like every time I play an overtime period, my thoughts are do whatever I have to do to stop the puck. And in that situation, I also caught myself a little bit out of position, but I saw the puck the whole way through, so I just tried to put my body in front of it, and it ended up working out.
Square your shoulders.
Yeah.
For the both of you, that's your second hockey championship. Is it sweeter to win against Boston College?
Yeah. I mean, I think last year we expected to play them, and to actually play them this year and win it again is unbelievable. We didn't have a lot of people on our side before the game, but I had 24 other teammates that believed in me, and we all believed in each other, and that's all we needed. And we obviously had our coaches.
Yeah, I think it's a testament to our team that we can beat anyone in the country, and even though we had to play UConn in the finals this year, and BC obviously this year has been a stronger team, we were able to beat them as well. So I think it just speaks to the strength of our team and the depth we have, and the ability we had to just stay focused throughout the entire game and rally together.
For both of you, going into overtime, what was the energy like in the locker room?
I know Paige Kapstran stepped up and said, hey, we can't change what happened. Yeah, that goal sucks in the last couple seconds, but we need to forget about it right now and play the next overtime smart. And we need to be all over them from the drop of the puck because we need to take the momentum back. We obviously had a good third period, and to get scored on in the last couple seconds isn't easy to deal with. But we knew we were going to be okay, and it was a fresh start, so we had to go out and fly.
Yeah, I agree with Cass on that. A lot of people in the locker room were chipping in and saying things, just stay positive. We can't control what happened, whatever play happened, whatever. All we had to do was focus on our next shifts and go play simple and defend first, and hopefully the goals will come.
Come on for the players for the...
Yeah, in the first half of the game, it looked like it was you against Watts having your own inner battle. I mean, do you relish that kind of competition where you're going against a great player like that, and she's testing you, you're foiling her? And
yeah, it's always fun to play against a really good team, and even more fun when you come up on top, and I think she's had a fair amount of goals on me, so anytime I can save a puck that she shoots is a good feeling for me, but I'm sure she'll be back at it next year and the following.
Any other players? All right, Cassie, Aaron, thank you. Congratulations.
Thanks.
You head back to the locker.
Thank you.
Questions for Coach?
They talked about resetting the clock to 7.8. They reset it to 7.4. I don't really know what happened. I know somebody said a notebook flew on the ice, and I don't know why the whistle wasn't blown, but we didn't talk about it much. I'm not even sure. They didn't tell me why they reviewed the goal, and the only thing I knew was that they review every goal in the playoffs, but they were over there for a while, so I don't know. They didn't even tell me what they were looking at or what they saw, so I'm not sure.
Just kind of a roller coaster of emotions to go from thinking you guys had scored the empty net goal to basically seal it and then have that happen, have
Yeah, you know, I told them, hey, listen, you know, control what we can control. And I tell them that a lot. And, you know, our effort was going to be one of the most important things that we can control going into that overtime. And I said, you know what, we just got to go out there, lay it all on the line, and from the drop of the puck, get all over them. And I thought they did a really good job. And like I said, seeing the way we started overtime, I felt good. I felt confident that we were going to get it done.
Anything else, Coach? How's the Gatorade bet?
I smell right now, so I'm trying to figure out if like I need to wash my suit or what. But if, I don't know what was in there, if it was dirty water, or I just need to wash my clothes. But I'm freezing right now. But I'll take it any day.
Can you move on quickly? If there's a good chance that you could face this team again in the NCAAs, what are your thoughts about that?
Yeah, well, you know, if that happens, we need to, you know, at least we know a lot about our opponent. So the game prep isn't as detailed, you know. But whoever we play, it's a new season, and we're one game away from the Frozen Four. And this program's never done that before. And with this group, I've told them since day one, they can beat anybody in the country if, you know, they put their minds to it and they stay together as a team. And I think we proved that today, too.
If Erin plays the way she did during this tournament, how far do you think this team can go?
Far. You know, sky's the limit for this team. And it starts with your goaltending. And championships are won with great goaltenders. You can look back through the history. There's probably not a lot of Stanley Cups or hockey's championships or anything where the goalie didn't play well. It's just so important, and she gives our team a lot of confidence. And so with her in net, I feel like we can beat anybody.
Any
answer,
Coach? All right, Coach, thank you. Congratulations,
everyone. I appreciate all your help.